So, let's say for people who are working, and we can give some advices how they can properly engage their occupation in Krishna consciousness.
Well, if you're gonna live in a temple, make your home a temple, make an altar, have Krishna there, worship him, worship Krishna with your family, sit down, chant morning, evening, whenever possible, hear, play a class or read from the book, read the purport, try to give some elaboration, you know, Shravanam, Kirtanam. Call people, make a feast, call people, give them prasadam, give them chanting. And support the temple. It is given by Prabhupada for the householders. They are obliged. Because householder life is a concession for some sense gratification, you see? They can, it's more, a little more loose, and they can enjoy. That's why it's there. Men and women together, they enjoy. Naturally. So you pay for it, if we put it like in a gross way. You pay for it. And you support those who are renounced, the brahmacharis, the sannyasis. You give your money to the temple. You maintain your family, you maintain your life, but also give to the temple. You offer the results to the preachers, to those who are actively and 100% engaged in the service. You do your service, you do not neglect, but you also support. Give money, in other words. The results of your labor, because you have to work. Either you live in a temple, husband and wife, but there is no, you know, mechiche. You live separately and you follow everything in the, what is in the temple. Or when you live separate, then you have your pleasures and that's okay. But you, because you work fruit, that you have to offer. You have to renounce the fruits of your labor. That is how you remain on the transcendental platform, Karma Yoga. Karma Yoga, when it is properly executed, is not different from Bhakti Yoga. Different and not different at the same time. But the quality of work is the same. The quality of work, devotion. So that shows how we are actually surrendered to the spiritual master. All these householders, you know, they should support. Who is supporting? You don't have to support us. Okay, you support us. We're trying our best. But who are you supporting, first of all? You're a householder. Show me which temple you support. You do not have a temple. Is your place open to anyone and everyone? Any junkie, any heroin addict from the street can come and take shelter at your place? To get purified, and you're gonna feed him prasadam, and you're gonna engage him in devotional service, and you're gonna fight with him when he gets, you know, when the horns grow. Or anyone, not just junkies, this is not just for the junkies, anyone, any puffed up nonsense will come from the street to get purified. Can you do that? No. So, it's not a temple. There's a, oh, I serve Krishna, I have a temple.
Your grace.
There you go. Prabhu, can you give a donation? Can you please support? No, I also have my preaching. I also preach. What is the preaching? You fry pakoras and then you eat with your family? What preaching are you doing? Can anyone come to your place and take prasadam and stay there? Not that they just take prasadam. Can he stay there? Can he move into your house and practice Krishna consciousness? No. So what kind of temple? That is not a temple. Maybe a namahad or whatever. But what? Preaching, you have to preach. If you do not preach, then you have to support the preachers. Otherwise you're out. You're out of the instruction of the guru. You do not follow. Your chanting is faulty, your hearing is faulty, your whole, everything is faulty. Your puja of your deities is faulty. Everything wrong. Half chicken, half hen logic. Oh, these eggs, this bum, you know, this is very nice. This cloaca, or how it's called. It's very nice, because eggs are coming. Yeah? Oh, so I have my deity, I have my prasadam, I have my recognition, oh Prabhu, you know? Yes. But this beak, you know, this head, oh, such a botheration, I have to feed it. These brahmacharis, these rascals, simply lying down on the floor and, you know, taking perfume. Then you do not see how we're getting punched in the face on the street. How, you know, the demons spit. That you do not recognize. You just see how we, how the brahmachari go. Because you're envious, because you have given up that liberty to go anywhere and everywhere, wherever you want. You just pack your five plums, like we say in Slovakia, in Czech. You pack your five plums and you go wherever you like. So that you have given up for sex. So that's okay. But why are you envious? That is brahmachari life also. That he can just chill. He has no obligation other than to serve the guru. So he does that. And when he becomes tired, he can chill. He can chill the whole day. He can take a week off if he wants to get energy. You can't do that. You have to work. You are forced. So you are simply envious. Why am I preaching? What preaching? When you give money, that is your preaching. Because you give to the preachers, that means you are preaching. So this is how they engage. They have to make their place available, at least one, you know, at least so people can come for some few hours, you know, at least once a week they should make a fee, something should be there.
That is a temple.
Okay, so the household they don't have to make.
No, I'm saying that's the definition of a temple.
Okay, but let's say a householder, they have a place.
Yeah.
And you can't move there, you can't go there, and, you know, like join like a temple. But let's say they make a feast.
Wonderful.
Yeah, so it should be done, right?
That's a temple.
But you can't join there.
So, it's okay.
Okay.
It's okay. They can stay wherever they are. They preach, the householders preach, and then the brahmachari ashram that can be made separately.
Yeah. So, like that, you see?
It's not the duty of the preacher to shelter people, right?
Yeah, but that is like the... Yeah, otherwise, where would people go and get trained? There is no such a place where they can actually join.
No, they can also help out building up the brahmachari ashram. You can raise funds and...
But how the brahmacharis will come about if there is already... Not someone.
By hearing. How did we become devotees? By hearing. We have heard. We didn't join, by the way. Except Brahmachandra. By hearing. So that's okay if they do that, but they don't even do that.
Yeah, well then, that's the problem.
They don't do anything.
Well, if they do that, then they will also, you know, will be like, because they're already plugged in, so they will also do not hesitate to support.
Of course.
Because they understand.
Yeah, there's nothing to do with, you know, it's just a desire. It doesn't matter how much money you give,
yeah,
how you do the temple, this and that, but the desire must be there. Yeah, let's preach. Like we didn't have any place, right? Yeah, I had nothing. You had nothing. I remember I visited you in 2012 in that small place. There was nothing there. I couldn't even chant. The neighbor would turn off the electricity, you know, when we were chanting. So then he was threatening that he's not going to turn it back on if we go on in thick of winter. So we didn't have, but we had a desire. And then Krishna arranged everything else. So householders, it's not a disqualification.
See? Of course not.
On one hand they say, oh, we're equal. Oh, we also, you don't think that you're brahmachari, but... Oh, yeah, when you want to preach, all of a sudden there's no equality. Oh, we can't be a household and we're weak. So that's plain. That's not honest.
Yeah, the only qualification for devotional service is sincerity. So if one is sincere, he will understand the instruction of the guru and he will act on it.
One thing I would like to point out though, that we should be very careful because we might end up in that situation ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So, a little compassion or discretion we should always keep in mind. Yeah, internally, I'm not saying that.
And there is a, like
the truth should not be spoken, but we should always think that we also can end up in that situation, you know. It's very unfortunate, you know, especially, you know, nowadays. And the girls are also very spoiled, right, because there's no training for the girls, so they're coming just out of the Western materialistic atmosphere, so the girls have no idea, you know, how to serve the husband, and they just basically they pollute him. It's a fact. Or the man is not strong enough, but it's difficult, you know, it's not easy. Not easy. If the woman is not submissive, then the man just can't handle it and he falls down. Unable to control, because the man has to lord it over, right? So if the woman is serving nicely, submissive, no arguing, this is like a Vedic wife, then the man is not going to feel lusty. The lust comes because the woman is argumentative and she rebels. That's why the man falls down. And when the man falls down, it's the end for both. You know? So the girls, they should. This feministic idea is so deep-rooted, it created such a damage in the society. Because from degradation of womanhood to everything else, right? So the women are very degraded, more than men. It's a fact. And by nature, they follow the authority. Right? The men are a little rebellious, and that is their fortune. But the women are completely just taken by this materialistic brainwashed propaganda. And the man cannot train them because, you know, you're not supposed to hang out with women. So this is the root problem of all problems. This Vikash, Bhakti Vikash, you know, he was explaining in his book. I read that book. He gave the realization, it's true. Those female devotees who are following the principles, they should preach. Very much needed to preach to the young girls, not to men. You know, oh, you're too fanatical and this and that. No, why are you preaching to men? You preach to the young ladies. How to be submissive, how to be chaste, how to follow the husband. But, you know, these elderly devotees, they're also nonsense, these female disciples. I mean, not all of them, but they're also. They're criticizing, oh, the women are being suppressed and they're fighting for women's rights. This is not Prabhupada's instruction. This is completely off. If you want to fight for women independent, teach the young ladies to be submissive. Not argue with their husband. That's the greatest feminism, just like Prabhupada. Prabhupada never said to his women disciples, you should fight for your rights and stand up and that. Where is this coming from? Why? See, the female disciples, if they're disciples, they should preach what Prabhupada says. Where Prabhupada says this? Stand up for your rights and this and that. It's nonsense. That's actually damaging the girls. Because the man will, you know, so agitated with such nonsense, women. They don't know anything. The Western culture is so low class and they're so puffed up. They'll argue. Argue with Prabhupada. I just, you know, I was posting something on Facebook. I just posted Prabhupada's quote and they're all rebelling against Prabhupada. They're, oh, this is not true. What? It's Prabhupada. Don't you get it? It's Prabhupada, my God. So, because you're criticizing Prabhupada, that means you're a cheater, number one. You're not a devotee, you're not a disciple, you're nonsense. Like you said, half and logic. It's nothing to do with man or female, this and that. Prabhupada is Prabhupada. Prabhupada is beyond male or female. See, they think materially, oh, Prabhupada says because he's a man. So that means you're mudha, you think that the spiritual master is not a man. The third offense. Your chanting is useless. You learn absolutely nothing. You're just a bunch of sentimental women, you know, who know nothing. And because you have no husband, no man to guide you, then you remain on the sentimental platform. a fact. So this is, I don't know how to explain this to the Western people. It's such a controversial point that they've been trained to resist this sort of philosophy. They've been brainwashed to think that this is actually the opposite. That is, you know, suppressing the women, this kind of philosophy. It's the other way around. It's protect the women. So we have to learn how to present this with humility and get ready to be beaten and criticized and stones thrown at you, because this is the society of demons. Jai, Shri Prabhupada.
Is there anything there?
The floor is saying Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
With heart.
Heart for Krishna.
Srinivas Prabhu is saying all glories to Prabhupada.
Okay, any questions there?
No. Here I can't see any more questions or comments. That's it.
Thank you. Oh, Gita ki jai. Jai.